What we have here really nicely demonstrates some of the variability we will see in soil sampling. One of the things that's very important in soil sampling is to look at a map of your soil before you go out to see if the field you're sampling in is uniform or has different soil types. Right here, we just finished sampling that field, and this is a core from it. And you can see that it's a very uniform, looks very consistent core. When we just crossed an arbitrary dirt road separating the bear field from the pecan orchard, what we found was an entirely different type of soil on the other side of an arbitrary road. So here, again, we see that we've sampled to the same depth, but there are some different things going on here. First of all, since this is a grassy area, we notice right on top that there's a lot of plant material and even some of the grass sticking in. Typically, when we're using this for testing, we're going to actually just remove this particular part of the core because it has so much organic material that's not representative of the soil. But perhaps more importantly is to notice that in this core, where everything is nice and uniform, we have a change in our soil texture right here. So while this is a clay loam soil, and the surface soil here is a clay loam, right below it at about 6 inches, 6.5 inches below the soil surface, we have a sand deposit. And you can see that that is an entirely different soil. So that would have been deposited differently. And that tells us because this one is uniform, and this one has two different layers or two different depths, we're dealing with two different types of soils. Hence, we need to take two different types of soil samples. The other thing we might consider doing, depending on how we are managing, is separating out the clay portion of the core and the sand portion of the core for different testing, because they're going to have very different nutrient holding capacities.